In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to program a heartbeat monitor using a standard webcam. Before getting into the MATLAB coding, let's discuss some of the basic physics of the project. So our skin color changes very slightly when blood pulses in our body. We will measure these color changes using the green pixels from a standard webcam. A standard webcam uses 8-bit grayscale for each color, which means that there are 256 different green intensities that can be measured. The lowest intensity is 0, and the highest is 255. However, the subtle color changes from our skin are much smaller than the distance between two consecutive intensity levels. To get a more sensitive measure of color changes, we'll average the fluctuations over many pixels. I'll show you how to amplify the green fluctuations in a box set by a face detection algorithm. Here's the video that I generated using MATLAB. I have an iPhone app to check that the program gave the same result. This program turns out to be fairly robust to small movements of my head. So let's go through the MATLAB code for a heartbeat monitor. In this first section, we just run some initialization commands. Let's run this section in advance. We now read in a video I made using Apple's photo booth. We get the number of frames, frame rate, and width for use later in the program. We also define freq underscore divisions, which is used to convert Fourier transform coordinates to frequency units. Lastly, we open an image viewer that shows the first frame of the video. Let's run in advance. In this section, we use a computer vision package that uses the Viola-Jones face detection algorithm to find the region where we are interested in analyzing the heartbeat. Face underscore box returns a row vector with four elements. The first element gives the x coordinate, the second the y coordinate, the third is the number of pixels in x, and the fourth is the number of pixels in y. The box is a square, so the third and fourth elements are the same. Let's run in advance. We have successfully created a box on my face. In this section, we define the dimensions of the box. Let's run in advance. This section averages the green pixels in the box on my face, but keeps the blue and red unchanged. Run and advance. We have now generated a single large green box that has very small fluctuations in time. The average of this box in green may be 140, but the fluctuations may be 0.1. We want to subtract the average value of 140 so that we can amplify the changes. Let's run and advance. You can see what the fluctuation signal looks like. These spikes are the heartbeat. These other slow or fast changes may be interesting physiological processes, but we're not going to worry about them. We'll filter out these frequencies using the Fourier transform. In this section, we take the fast Fourier transform. The Fourier transform allows us to look at frequency content of our signal. The heartbeat is a frequency that we measure in beats per second. A typical resting heartbeat is a little more than one beat per second. You can see the heartbeat frequency. In the correct units, this shows that there are strong fluctuations about every second. In this section, we filter out some of the not so important frequencies of our signal. We do this by setting frequencies lower than 0.66 Hz and higher than 4 Hz to 0. This corresponds to a little less than 40 beats per minute and greater than 240 beats per minute. Let's run in advance. You can see now that we have a dominant heartbeat peak and almost everything else is small or zero. In this section, we perform the inverse fast Fourier transform on the filtered frequency content. This now gives us a time signal again. Let's run and advance. You can now see that we have a much cleaner time fluctuating signal. In this section, we take the filtered signal, amplify it, and add the time average signal back on. This gives us the same average value as before, but the fluctuations associated with the heartbeat are much larger now. You can see that we have larger fluctuations centered around our average value. Here we write a video called heartbeatamplify.avi. In this nested for loop, we go frame by frame and set the green value in the box equal to the amplified signal we just generated. We close the video. Let's run this section. Let's open the video file we just generated. It is interesting to compare the color with the heartbeat monitor signal. I hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe if you'd like to see more content and tune in for more.